Good day. My name is Andrea Ockes. Our group presentation is based on capital structures and leverages, which we consider as of utmost importance to a financial manager within any firm. Leverage refers to the fixed cost asset employed by the firm. This directly affects the firm's return, its risk, as well as its share price. The degree of operating leverage has an effect on the firm with regards to the composition of its capital structure. The financial manager should therefore consider optimal capital structure. This report will advise Anglo Mineral Inc. on which capital structure to pursue in order to obtain the goal of maximizing the share price. I will now be handing over to Etienne Van Wyk.
Good day, my name is Etienne. I'll be explaining the capital structure study summary of Anglo Minerals Incorporated. As we can see from this table, we've got the different capital structures, the EPS values at the different public abilities, which is at 35, 50 and 15% respectively, the expected EPS, standard deviation, as well as the coefficient of variance of EPS. The first step would be for us to calculate the EPS at the different probabilities. This would be done by calculating the EBIT value. We would take the sales associated with the different probabilities, lessing the fixed cost, which would be 322,000, and lessing the variable cost, which is 38% of the sales. By doing that, we would get our EBIT values for the different probabilities. The next step would be calculating the earnings available to common stockholders. And this will be done by taking our EBIT values, lessing the interest associated with the capital structures, and we get earnings before taxes. From the earnings before taxes, we then less the taxes, which is 35% of the earnings before tax, and then we get our earnings available to common stockholders. The last step would then be calculating our EPS. This would be done by taking our earnings available to common stockholders and dividing it by the number of shares outstanding. And by doing that, we would get our different EPS values for the different probabilities. The next step would then be calculating our expected earnings per share. This would be done by calculating the sum of the different probabilities multiplied by the different EPS values associated with those probabilities. And some of that would give us our expected earnings per share for the different capital structures, as we can see over here. The next step will be calculating our standard deviation. Standard deviation will be calculated by taking the sum of the square root of the probability multiplied by the EPS minus the expected earnings per share, that squared, and the sum of that will give us our standard deviation. The next step will be calculating our coefficient of variance, and this will be done by taking our standard deviation and dividing it by our expected EPS values, and this will give you our coefficient of variation of EPS. I will now be handing over to Andrea, and she will be explaining the relationship between EPS and the debt ratios.
The EPS, or earnings per share, serves as an indicator of the company's profitability, while the debt ratio serves or illustrates the capital structure of the company. So with regards to our graph, the graph summarizes the seven capital structures: 0%, 10%, 20%, 35%, 45%, 55%, and 65% respectively. At 65% we have our peak. The EPS is 18 rand and 33 cents, where it is 0% debt ratio is our lowest capital structure. The EPS is at 8 rand 41 cents. I'll now be handing over to Ruwaye.
Hi, I'm Ruwaye, and I'll be explaining the graph that shows the relationship between the debt ratio and the coefficient of variations of earnings per share. Now, the coefficient of variations of earnings per share is a measure of relative dispersion that is useful in comparing the risk of assets and the differing expected returns. That simply means that it is the risk relative to the expected earnings per share. Now, looking at our graph, we can see that as the debt ratio increases, the coefficient of variations of earnings per share increases. This means that as the financial leverage increases, the coefficient of variations of earnings per share increases. That simply means, further defined, that as the financial leverage increases, the risk also increases, which makes sense because the more money you borrow, the larger the uncertainty of your ability to pay it back and make a reasonable return. Now I'm going to hand it over to Bronwyn, who's going to make our recommendations and conclusions.
Good day everyone, I'm Bronwyn. I hope you're all doing good. Now the value of the firm is maximized when the cost of the capital is minimized. As you can see, that 65% is preferred capital structure if the financial manager of the Anglo Minerals Incorporated wants to maximize its EPS. As you can also see, that 65% is also the preferred capital structure if the financial manager of Anglo Minerals Incorporated wants to maximize its share value. Now, if the firm wants to go into the profit maximization route, then the firm would use the EPS. If the firm wants to use the wealth maximization route, then the firm will use the share value. In conclusion, wealth maximization takes into account the risk associated with capital structure, but the EPS does not. That is why the financial manager of Anglo Minerals Incorporated would choose the wealth maximization.